question what he has announced and he has enacted in assembly against the statutory body Waqf Board's natural impactment. I was told by our people the legitimate right of Waqf Board has been stolen in Kerala state by this state government. The recruitment right is the legitimate right of the Waqf Board. How dare a state government gives this power to some other body or organization to proceed? Waqf Board is centrally constituted legitimate body. It was constituted in 1954, and the fulfillment of the acts has been made in 1995. The necessary and essential amendments were adopted in 2013. I was having an opportunity of participating in the debate of 2013 Waqf amendment in the parliament. I feel proud of that. Today I am the chairperson of Tamil Nadu Waqf Board. All our brothers and dignitary leaders were exploring their delightment of sentiments to say that Abdul Rahman is the Tamil Nadu Waqf Board president, Waqf Board chairman. A small correction needs to be made to our respected leaders. I can say the chairmanship of Tamil Nadu Waqf Board was not given to an individual Abdul Rahman. It was given to the great party of our organization, Indian Union Muslim League. That is true. Don't you think that there are several deserving dignitaries and personalities in ruling party DMK? There are more. Do you think that they could not find any deserving and qualified personality in the ruling party DMK? There are. But the Honorable Chief Minister M.K. Stalin has chosen Indian Union Muslim League is the only organization to manage the Waqf Board in the whole Tamil Nadu state. This is the first time the chairpersonship has been given to Indian Union Muslim League in the history of Tamil Nadu. Our party has chosen me to be the president and the chairman of the Waqf Board. It doesn't mean that I am the only person available in Indian Union Muslim League. There are so many deserving dignitaries in Indian Union Muslim League Tamil Nadu unit. But what to do? Only one person is to be nominated. So that my name has been declared by our national president. But this is my responsibility. It is indispensable responsibility to safeguard the reputation and fame of our Indian Union Muslim League in the state by protecting all the legitimate rights of the board, Waqf Board in Tamil Nadu. Here I can proudly say the Honorable Chief Minister M.K. Stalin has given the entire rights and privileges to Waqf Board to safeguard its own statutory rights. Whatever it may be, the decision we are taking. Do you know that in the very beginning, our Chief Minister has declared, government interference will not be there. Political interference will not be there in Waqf Board activities. But government will support in all steps and efforts what we are taking to safeguard the rights and properties and value of ethics of Tamil Nadu Waqf Board. This is the way a chief minister of the state should become as a model. Our respected Pinarayi Vijayan, honorable chief minister of Kerala state. Tamil Nadu is very nearby, neighboring state. Can't you see this? At least you are very experienced leader. You are experienced leader. Generously, we can say that you are a respectable leader. You are the chief minister of Kerala state. But what is the necessity of this legitimacy to be given to something else and somewhere other organization? Why you are plucking the legitimacy and the privileges from Waqf board? We have a very strong doubt there is a conspiracy behind it. Conspiracy behind it. What is the necessity arised to pluck the privileges of the recruitment from Waqf board and is given to PSC? In Indian history, no state has followed such kind of practice. No state has done this kind of plucking the privileges of Waqf board. Even the so-called RSS guidelined government, Uttar Pradesh also did not do that. How Kerala state has got into this kind of junk? In each and every part of social activities, our great leaders, Indian Union, Muslim League, have guided the front line and the remarkable model to the, not only to the community, not only to Kerala state, to the entire nation. Our respected, dignified leader, the founder president of Indian Union Muslim League, Qaid-e Millat Muhammad Ismail Sahib. Dignified leaders, Poker Sahib, Sidi Sahib, Pookoya Tangal Sahib, C.H. Muhammad Koya Sahib, Sayyid Muhammad Ali Shihab Tangal Sahib, Siraju Millat Abdus Samad Sahib. We can list out the very long list of our great Muslim League leaders. We feel proud of under such guidelines and the proud leadership of here, we could see the virtual presence of Sayyid Haider Ali Shihab Tangal Sahib. Let us all pray for his speedy recovery and good health and long life, inshallah. Ameen. You all should say Ameen. May Allah give long life and good health of our great leader Sayyid Haider Ali Shihab Tangal Sahib. His leadership and guidelines should continue for a long time on and on to the great community of this Kerala state, inshallah. Not only Kerala state, the entire community of the nation. The family, the glorious hereditary family merit we are having from Tangal family. We are all very much delighted and proud of having that kind of prestigious aspect. Here I could see our Rashid Ali Shihab Tangal Sahib. One day in Tamil Nadu, in Chennai, Waqf board meeting was going on. We could have a great opportunity of our former Waqf board chairman Rashid Ali Shihab Tangal Sahib in the premises of Tamil Nadu Waqf board building and inside office. The moment of what I was having his presence in the central, in the center figured point of Tamil Nadu Waqf board, I thought of the glorious impact we were having from Tangal family. We didn't invite, but all of a sudden his presence has been made by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbul Alameen. He has been there in the main building of Tamil Nadu Waqf board, in center figure of the point. In this juncture, I don't want to take a long time. In this juncture, we urge upon the state government to reconsider the resolution what has been adopted in the assembly, Kerala State Assembly. We will not get compromised once any kind of source or adverse impact to touch the legitimacy of minority community. We cannot get compromised on that. The state chief minister and the Kerala state authorities concerned should look into this mega rally and mammoth rally and the great gathering covered in the whole area. What is the sentiments? What is the feeling they should realize it? The government reality should be in such a way to respect the sentiments of the people, not to scratch that. Waqf Board is what? Waqf Board is the legitimate body, it's a statutory body to safeguard the properties given in the name of God by the philanthropist as a permanent charity for the cause of goodness. While we are using the property of Waqf, the Kerala State Waqf or any state Waqf, that utility and the usage is meant not only for Muslim community, but on contrary, it is meant for everybody's, irrespective of the religion, irrespective of the community, irrespective of the caste. So the philanthropists have dedicated the properties in the name of God for the benevolence, for the benefit, for the utilization of the public people. While we are doing that kind of management, there should not be any kind of interference on its own nature. What kind of conspiracy has been made against that legitimacy? Why? What kind of benefit this government, Kerala government, state government is going to look into that? Why you are creating a such kind of artificial act, artificial procedure by plucking out the privileges of Kerala State Waqf Board? What is the necessity arised? But fortunately, the constitution has already made this Waqf Act in 1954 and fulfilled in 1995. And as per the CWC, Central Waqf Council, in 1964, they put very definitely and particularly the chairman and members of the board should be from Muslim community. They have very well defined on that. Same way, chief executive officer is to be from the Muslim community to safeguard the properties dedicated by Muslim philanthropists. So itself is an indication of the privileges of all Waqf activities will be carried out by the Muslim community at the same time for the benefit of all community people. It was well defined in the act. All of a sudden, by having a small gap, you have penetrated your poisonous impact by plucking out the privilege of Waqf Board by saying that recruitment will be made for Waqf Board through PSC. So by having this opportunity in this mammoth, after this mammoth rally and this marvelous gathering, we appeal the Honorable Chief Minister of Kerala State, Pinarayi Vijayan, not only on behalf of the huge gathering of this act, this event, as the Tamil Nadu Waqf Board Chairman, myself including in that, we all together appeal the Honorable Chief Minister of Kerala State, Shri Pinarayi Vijayan Ji, to withdraw your proposal, to withdraw the enactment of this resolution of the recruitment of Waqf Board to PSE. You please bring back the privilege and legitimacy to Waqf Board. You have to standardize it. This is the expectation of the people. Not only the minority community, Muslim community people. The so-called generous people of all communities in Kerala state are anxiously waiting for your withdrawal of that resolution. I would like to conclude my speech in brief in this occasion. Not only in this subject, in particularly Kerala state, in general all over India, any kind of adverse impact on the legitimate rights of minority Muslim community, Indian Union Muslim League is strongly determined to oppose, to raise the voice, whatever it may be the consequence we may have to face, in order to safeguard our rights and privileges. Inshallah, our continuous effort will go ahead, will go on to protect our rights, to safeguard our own legitimacy in this country, irrespective of the state. Inshallah, with the unity, with the cooperation and coordination of all community people in the nation, by leading with the spirit of Indian Union Muslim League. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Thank you, sir.